Hi, welcome to How to Repair. Have you got a tumble dryer that you're putting the clothes into the drum, it runs for 10 to 15 minutes and then turns itself off automatically, but the clothes may be slightly warm but not dry? Then this is the video for you. Lot of tumble dryers from all manufacturers now come with sensor dry systems. Let me quickly explain how this works. You have humidity or moisture sensors inside the drum that detect how dry the clothing is. And basically, when the clothing is dry, those sensors tell the program to turn the machine off and let it do its final 10-minute cooling down period. If these sensors are faulty in any way, then your dryer will turn off automatically. But you need to establish whether the machine is heating first, because if the machine is not heating, then it would be a different type of fault to do with the heating system. Now, if you have a vented condenser or even a heat pump tumble dryer, they all use these humidity or moisture sensors inside the drum to detect whether the clothing is still wet. But the first thing you need to establish is whether the machine is heating with vented and condenser tumble dryers, or whether the compressor system is running on heat pump tumble dryers. And the way that you would do this is using an amperage meter, which you can easily have for your house. And I'll put a link in the description below to these meters and a video that I did on tumble dryers showing you how these meters actually detect the amount of power being used. They're very worthwhile having. So let's get on with this fault. This machine was running for 10 to 15 minutes and turning itself off automatically, but the heating system was working. The way you can determine this is set it to the highest heat setting on your sensor dry system, not the timed system, on only the sensor dry system. Once you've set it to the program, start the machine. You then need to establish whether the heater is working correctly. Now, the heater on this tumble dryer is about a 2.2 kilowatt. And if we look at the meter up here, you can see that I'm drawing 2.3 kilowatt, meaning 100 watt or so is being used for the motor, and 2.2 kilowatt is being used for the heating system. So we know there's not a problem with the heating system itself. And this means that we could have a problem with a moisture sensor or humidity sensor inside the drum or the ducting system. Okay, we're in the tumble dryer now, and I've managed to get all the camera and lighting set up in the back of the dryer. Bit of a squeeze. Basically, what we're explaining here is the clothing goes into the dryer when it's damp. The dryer comes on, but may only run for 10-15 minutes and turn itself off, and you're thinking, why are my clothes still wet? Once you've established that the heater is in good condition and actually drawing power, but the dryer is turning off early with the sensor dry, then you know that you've got a fault with one of the sensors on the machine. Now, a lot of manufacturers use these bars that you can see here, which are moisture sensors. They measure the amount of water, humidity sensor or moisture sensor. They measure the amount of water in the drum air or in the air. And what each program has is a predetermined resistance value. So, for example, we have three programs here that I'll mention. Cupboard dry, extra dry, cupboard dry, normal, and easy iron. Each one of those programs would have a different resistance value built into the program. The cupboard extra dry will nearly want zero resistance. The cupboard dry would want a slightly higher resistance. And the easy iron would want a lot higher resistance because it wants the clothes to come out of the drum slightly moist, ready for ironing. If these two bars build up a film on them, now when I say a film, like a greasy tarnish on top of the bars, the computer will be getting a false reading. And this means that it would turn the dryer off early because it thinks the clothes are dry, but they're not dry. And this was the problem with this dryer. There was a large film on top of these two bars. And the way you rectify this, excuse me, I dropped my cloth, is use a soft cleaning cloth with a bit of white vinegar, which will dissolve any fabric or particles that build up on the bar, and give the bar a good clean, both bars. Once the computer is getting the correct resistance values, it will dry for a longer period of time until the moisture level has changed to the correct amount that the program is set at. Then it will shut off the heating system and allow the dryer to do its last 5-10 minutes cooling down period. This applies to vented tumble dryers, condensing tumble dryers, and heat pump tumble dryers that have these bars in them. On some other manufacturers, they use a different circuit. They will have a sensor maybe in the airflow, which goes through from here at the bottom and goes down either to the condenser or to the vent tube, and it may be measuring the moisture in the air there. But a lot of manufacturers use this bar system or humidity sensor, and this will actually rectify the problem for you. And there you go, such a simple repair, and it didn't cost you any money. Remember, we have multiple videos at the website on tumble dryer repairs, from changing belts to heater systems, thermostats, and so on. Also, I would recommend you actually watch the video in the link in the description about using meters to understand what appliances draw in electricity. It will save you no end of money in the future. Please remember to shop at How to Repair for tumble dryer spares, as that's what keeps us going and able to make these videos for you. I'd also like to thank RDS International for supplying us the machines. They deal with the trade and trade only, and you'll see all about them at the end of this video. Thank you very much indeed for watching, and remember, if we really helped you, you can always click on the Buy Paul a Beer page. Thanks again for watching.
RDS International is leading the way in environmental responsibility, exclusively serving trade customers, businesses and shops. We're committed to ensuring white goods don't end up in landfills. Operating throughout the UK, we strictly adhere to the WE directive, guaranteeing that appliances are disposed of in compliance with regulations. Beyond mere disposal, we breathe new life into refrigeration units by repurposing them for developing nations. And a special note for our trade partners: for every load we dispose of on your behalf, we pledge to plant a tree, ensuring it springs to life. Our primary objectives are distinct: to protect our environment, support global communities, and address Europe's escalating white goods dilemma.